The Google Art project is pretty straightforward, pretty simple, honestly. Basically, you can choose from a number of galleries and museums around the world, and you can look at their artworks as the slide form, or you can go around the floor plan and see what it looks like in the actual gallery. So you see, you know, you can see this Rembrandt here, and you can see probably not a full selection, but a pretty broad selection of images that are in the museum. And also, if you know, if you look over to the right here, you can see a description in Dutch and a little bit more information, which is probably pretty exciting for the students in this project that I would be teaching, just because they would be able to see actual information. And usually Google will go ahead and translate this. I wonder, actually, yeah, translate into English here. You can see all this information that you wouldn't necessarily see if you were just doing a Google image search or something. But for me, the really exciting thing is that you can go back to the museum itself and you can look at what these images look like in the gallery. And that's part of the project that I'm going to be teaching my students, is to think about the way that the curator has decided to set up the artwork in the gallery itself. This is not a really great example. Let me see if I can find something else. Let's go to the MoMA in New York and see what we have there. So yeah, see, the way that the curator has decided to put these two images next to each other, both Cezanne's, I think, yeah, was obviously sort of influenced by the fact that they have a common creator, but that's not always the case, you know. I mean, obviously, the decision here to put a landscape next to a still life is a decision that someone had to make, so that's part of the project here, and it's, I think, important that students be able to see what it looks like to have two different pieces next to each other and how they sort of influence each other to the viewer. And that's really an option that you don't get unless you're actually in the museum until now, really. So it's pretty exciting, relatively straightforward in terms of the way that the technology is actually used. And yeah, I think just is a good opportunity.